initially I thought, yeah, I should not apply for this exam. One reason is that the number of vacancy. Another one is that I do not have an exam center in my home state. I have to travel to another state and appear for the exam. So which will be taking around 12-13 hours a train journey I have to do, and I have to appear for an exam. So initially I thought, yeah, I should not appear for this because it's a waste of time, waste of money. You have to spend a lot of money. You have to go there and stay there. Room rent and all is so high, right? No?
Hello everyone, welcome to iExam B, and today I have with me Chilanka Teresa Francis, who has become a UPI Forex officer. So many, many congratulations, Chilanka.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you for taking out time, Chilanka, to come and share with us. It has been a long journey and a long struggle for you to become an officer in the bank. So great to be sharing that with you. We have talked before also many times during your preparation, and I'm so glad to be finally interviewing you today for a success story. So to give a brief background, Chilanka did her MBA in 2019, and she's also worked with various companies on the working capital management profile. But she always wanted to work in a bank, and she has been preparing for these exams from a lot of years, so we will hear it from Chilanka herself. So Chilanka, when and how did you start preparing for exams, and how has your journey been like?
I did my graduation in 2016. I passed out in 2016. So basic qualification you need to appear in a bank exam is graduation.
Right.
So I started appearing from then, like from 2016, it's now 2024. So it was a very long journey. In between that, I did my post-graduation. I got married. I worked for 3-4 years. So everything was happening in between, but I don't want to lose this opportunity, like this passion I have in me. So this is my last year to appear for any bank exam. Like I'm 29 now. By the time I reach 30, like there's difference in
notifications,
months.
Huh? Yeah. Notifications may or may not come, right?
May not come. So I'm 29 now. I'm writing from 22, I think. Yeah, finally. Somehow I didn't lose that hope. One time I'll get into it, no? Yeah, right. That happened.
Great. So what would you say? You know, sometimes it's like the last time lucky thing may work, but what would you say was different this time in comparison to, you know, so many years you've been writing the exam?
Yeah. I have written exams with around 3,000 vacancies, and I couldn't qualify even the prelim. But this time there was only 30 vacancies in the general category. Total there were 73.
And in 73.
General category,
You mean the unreserved category, right?
Yeah, unreserved category. There was only 30. I appeared in that category, and I couldn't. Mm-hmm. I could get into that. You know, you really have to work hard. There is no alternative, I would say. These 8 years, I would, if I ask myself, no, I have made mistakes. I have been lazy many times. I've not worked many times. But this time, no, I really wanted it. There is no other way. This is the last time I could appear, especially. Specifically, I would say Forex profile interested. There was an interest. Mm-hmm. Initially, I thought, yeah, I should not apply for this exam. One reason is that the number of vacancy. Another one is that I do not have an exam center in my home state. I have to travel to another state and appear for the exam. So which will be taking around 12-13 hours a train journey I have to do, and I have to appear for an exam. So initially I thought, yeah, I should not appear for this because it's a waste of time, waste of money. You have to spend a lot of money. You have to go there and stay there. Room rent and all is so high,
right.
No?
Right.
Everything
right.
is there, yeah. Initially I thought, yeah, I should not apply. But then my husband told me, you just give a try. What you have written so many exams, you have failed so many times. Now, failure is not a new thing for you, no? Just try, what is wrong in that? You should go, exam center was in Chennai. So you thought we will hang around Chennai and we'll come back. Don't worry, don't take too much heart. Just take it lightly. But then I thought, no, he's spending so much. I should do some justice to it, no? So then initially I thought I'll work with the materials I have in my hand, like the MBA materials.
Okay.
We had a paper, International Finance.
Okay.
So initially I took all my textbooks and started revising. But then I made the same mistake while I appeared for PNB credit officer last year. I've appeared for that examination and I've appeared for the interview too. But that mistake I made there, because I studied just with my textbooks and notes I had that time. But when you appear for a competitive exam, now the pattern is different, the type of question they ask is different. So I understood that the mistake I made that time was that I didn't go for a proper, I didn't purchase the course, I didn't do that properly. So this time, since the vacancies are very less, I at least has to qualify the examination. There is no other way, because it takes a lot of effort for me to go there and appear for the examination.
Right, right.
So I should not leave it with an ease. No, I really have to work hard this time. At least I have to qualify the examination. No matter, there is no other way I can, because it's the last time. It's such a good profile. What if I get into it? No, you never know what will happen.
Right.
So somehow I really wanted. There is no other way I have in my hand in before me.
So many very important points that you brought out, and I will repeat for the benefit of others also. This is very two classical mistakes that you are pointing and talking about, and I'm glad you are brought them up front, because it's very important. One classical mistake, as you mentioned, we think if the number of vacancies are more, our chances of getting in increases, but it's not as simple probability as just calculating the number of vacancies and your chances of getting in, because there are multiple factors. So people who understand probability, it's not such a simple question or numerical maths question to solve here, because number of vacancies increases also increases the number of aspirants. Somewhere down the line, it also, subconsciously in our mind makes us relax in terms of, how we are going to for it. Which may or may not be true for every individual, but this is definitely sure that just the increase in number of vacancies does not increase a person's probability of
getting selected.
I'm sure now, thinking back, you must be so glad you finally took that decision. You did not let go of not applying just because these were 30 vacancies as against 3,000 vacancies kind of exams that you've applied for in the past.
Because I'm not an extraordinary student or something. I've been struggling for many years to just qualify an exam. So it's not like you're only brilliant and you could qualify for less number of vacancies. I've written exams with so many number of vacancies and I couldn't qualify. But once I've heard there somewhere, one of these SARS on YouTube told me somewhere there will be an examination question paper set up just for you to qualify. Somewhere it will be there like that.
Right.
Like my weak area was this general awareness portion. So this exam, there was no general awareness.
No general awareness.
Yeah,
yes.
Somewhere there was this examination paper was set for me, I think.
Great. That's nice. Another good point that's coming out is it's good to be aware about your strengths. It's even better to be aware about your weaknesses, so that you can see how best you can make of your strengths and how best you can overcome your weaknesses. So it's very important to be aware about our own self. So that's a very good point. And second important point that I got from you is how to prepare for an exam, because this is absolutely true that what we are studying does give us a base of preparing for any competitive exam. That's what makes us eligible also. But there are certain nuances of certain exams, and if we pay attention to them, we definitely increase our chances and probability of getting through, right? So certainty is ultimately a result of your own hard work and luck also to some extent, but definitely working in that direction makes a lot of difference. So because I have also studied international finance, international business was my minor when I was doing MBA. But what we study there is very different from a forex officer's job. This is more banking operations understanding and trade finance understanding that becomes helpful. So only relying on one aspect sometimes may help, sometimes may not help. So definitely one should try to understand the exam and its requirements. So that's very, very important. And another point that I'll highlight in Sri Lanka's struggle, she has been highlighting how she's been struggling since 2016 to get in. But what I have noticed is how you also kept strengthening your profile, you know, rather than just thinking that I have to write a paper, preparing for it, which is also a relevant strategy to have. But even better is, you know, we are in a country where a lot of opportunities are also opening up, not just in the government, but overall in the country. So how you decided to, you know, do an MBA in between while writing papers, how you decided to work in the private sector also, and you worked for 3-4 years, which gave you a lot of practical experience of how working capital actually management is done outside of books, because on books we definitely study that, but outside of books in practical life, how it is it? All these things are very, very helpful overall. So how you worked on building your profile all these years, I will definitely not say there has been a failure. Maybe the success was delayed, that's all. But a lot of learning that has happened all on the way, Chinanka. So great. So once you decided that, you know, this is your last chance, no matter you have to travel for the exam, no matter there are less number of vacancies, once you put your mind to it, how did you start preparing for this exam actually?
First time when I saw the notification, I was actually on excitement, because I've never seen a scale one officer's post in Forex. I've seen scale two and three, and I've seen the notification, yes. But scale one for a fresher, this is first time I'm coming across such a notification. But at the time of preparation, I thought that this time, this is the last time, I should not make a mistake. I've made mistakes so many times. I should somehow learn from that mistake. Otherwise, mistakes will be repeating in our lives until we are learned, no? So this time I purchased a course. I looked into YouTube. So I saw 2-3 success stories of iExamB. So there were students were telling about how iExamB course helped them. So I purchased a course. I called a member in iExamB. So he told me about the course structure details and all. So I purchased the course, and there were video recorded sessions were there, PDFs were there, practice mocks were there. I went through everything. Like I think the examination, just before the examination, I had 15-16 days to prepare. So completely I didn't waste any time, because one thing is that I've been traveling this many times to reach the examination center. So some justice I should do to myself. Like I should not leave this like idle. I prepared really well with all the material, all the PDF. I took the printout of the PDF material. I continuously learned, thoroughly revised everything. I went through all the mock examinations. I completely, thoroughly went through the PDF. There was no topic I left unturned. Everything I learned that really helped me in the examination. There were QA, reasoning, math, plus professional knowledge, which carries more high weightage was there. I think around 200. 50% weightage was there. I wouldn't say I could cover every, I wrote every answer, but that was really helpful. If I stick with my MPA material now, I would have not even qualified the examination, because it's completely different. And iExamB course, there were no numericals. Examination also, no numericals were asked. So every way, it helped me a lot in qualifying the examination. But still then I was in doubt, because vacancies are very less. So chances of getting selection was very less. But I don't know how. Maybe this time God's grace was with me.
Sure. So God also helps those who help themselves. So maybe you put in the effort, and I hope what I'm taking from you is the advice that you took from the past success stories of taking the iExamB course was not bad. It worked in your favor.
Initially I thought, why should I spend money? I would stick with my MBA material. But then this same mistake I did with my PNB officer. Like, once you make a mistake, you have to learn from it, otherwise it gets repeated in your life.
So this is a good point, because you know, especially with the specialist officers, I will say we have to understand the exam. And I very categorically remember, because you brought out the point of numerical, so I am able to recall, because a lot of students actually, even on YouTube, even on Telegram, even, you know, within our course, used to say, ma'am, there are not enough numericals. Please do classes for numericals, please give us more numericals. And I kept stating that I'm doing it, I'm providing it, but do it as the last thing you have to do. And even if you have to skip it, skip it. because the probability of numericals coming in this exam is less than 5%, even 1% or something.
No, it was zero, I would say. No numericals.
Yeah. So no numericals came, that's there. But, you know, while preparing, I will not say zero probability, but I was quite sure not more than 1% probability of any numericals.
Thank God
that
I didn't spend much time on numericals.
So we have to understand the exam. Right. So one tip that I'll give to anybody is, it's not true across. It's not like numericals don't come in any exam. They come, but you have to understand the exam. You have to understand the requirement of the job and prepare accordingly. And once you understand the exam well, then your preparation, and if you stick to the preparation in that aspect, then very likely you are going to get through. And we have to treat it like a competitive exam. And not like a, you know, college or a school exam where you need to get 100 marks. We have to see the probability of things getting asked and cover those. And if you have time, then of course, everything under the sun, you should prepare. You can prepare, right? So that's there. Very, very important point. So once you cleared the exam and your name was there in the interview list, was there any separate preparation you did for the interview?
Interview preparation, ma'am, I think I got around more than 20 days for the interview. 22 days were there for the interview preparation I got. I went back to all the, since it was election time, the results got delayed. But I thought, what if I qualify for the examination? I should not waste the time now. Because I've faced so many failures, so failure is not a new thing. So I'm okay, used to that. So once you study something, it will never be waste. Somewhere, somehow it will be helpful to you. So I went back to the materials. I've been preparing, I was revising these materials during that time period also, before the results came to. I was preparing for the interview, even before the results were out. Because what if I qualify now? So I went through all the materials. Then I went to YouTube. I searched for this success stories again. Like, we'll get a bit and pieces of how the interview panel was, what questions were asked to them, how will be the structure and all. So I went through all these things, and I also prepared for the interview really well. My personal profile, the work experience I have, the things I studied, like my graduation, post-graduation, my projects, my internship. Anything can be asked, no? So I completely forgot everything, because I completed in 2019, so I have to brush up everything. I really worked hard. You know, if you really work hard, no? Everything is possible with God's grace.
Yes, absolutely. And how did your actual interview go? What type of questions did they ask?
Yeah, the panel was very cordial. They were very helpful, very friendly. Like, I was the last person to be interviewed on that particular day, so my interview last around 25 to 30 minutes. It started by around 7:15 p.m. and ended by 7:45 p.m. So when at the time I entered also, I think there were four male and one female member in the panel. At the time I entered, they asked me if you need water, if you need snacks, we can wait, no problem. You just have come, relax and come. They were very cordial, and questions were related to, they asked me to introduce myself. The most of the questions were related to letter of credit. Like revolving letter of credit, back-to-back letter of credit, then crystallization of exposed bills related data question was asked. And the main chairperson, he was like, at one point he said, like, you're continuously switching the jobs, you're continuously changing your jobs, you're changing your location. Now, how can we guarantee you? What if you got elected and you leave your job and go? They were like, a point they were triggering, not really triggering, but they were, I remained calm and said, I'm sorry, sir, I would like to disagree with you, because these are the things. I said it very politely. At that time, when I saw his expression, I felt like, yeah, he's impressed. I had a small little hope at that point, might be I may qualify. So then he asked me, like, another female member, she asked me, like, you've been working from home all your life. When you come to UBI, you are not allowed to work from home. You have to sit at office continuously for many hours and do the work. Then I said, like, spontaneously, somehow, I don't know that answer, how it came. Ma'am, I really wanted to work from office. I've been struggling. I've been bored sitting at home. I really wanted to come. I really wanted to come in office. And then somehow, from the facial expressions, I thought, like, she was laughing. The whole panel laughed when I said this answer. So I had hope at that point. And also, he asked me another question, which I couldn't answer. Two questions I couldn't answer. rest all I could answer, and also there were questions related to my weakness. They asked me about the weakness I have. Most of the questions were related to professional knowledge aspect. Then the main panel member, he asked me like, what is Forex? What all things you know about Forex? Just tell me. I just continuously talked about it for 5 minutes. So when I stopped, he asked me from which YouTube channel you got this. like that. I said like, sir, I really wanted to get into this job. So I did everything that I could get. Every other website, every other YouTube channel I referred, and at this time I really don't want to lose this chance. I've learned from every site I could study. Then and I said, so you can expect the same from if you select me also, sir. If you give me a job, I'll 100% do everything I could do from that. So somehow the conversation went well, and they asked me to take a chocolate and leave. And I was satisfied with the interview, but since this was with the examination mark and interview mark is counting, vacancies are very less, I was a bit tense. But interview was very nice, and you told me about like telling my experience about working capital.
Right.
So when I said that technical word, no, they were like very pleased, like since they were very happy to hear some technical words that I'm putting forward. And there were a discussion on what is this accounts receivables, what is payables, what do you do in your job, why did you leave it, all the questions were there. More they stick to professional knowledge.
Very, very similar, because I remember doing a detailed discussion about this in your mock interview.
Yes, ma'am, that helped me a lot because they asked that, point out that same thing. Yeah, if I was repeatedly saying accounts receivables and payables, it would have been a bit boring,
right.
But since I came up with that word of capital management, working capital management, the panel was happy. I believe so. I don't know.
Great, great. That's nice to hear, Sri Lanka. So so nice to see you finally being interviewing you today as a success story, and it's a pleasure, and wishing you all the best from our side for a very successful, fruitful, satisfying career as a Forex officer. And thanks again, Sri Lanka, for taking out time today. Anything else you
thank
want to say before we close?
Nothing, ma'am. I should thank you. That decision of choosing XMB material, studying from it, just sticking to that only one material during that examination point, attending the interview. I should really thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for all the help and guidance and support and everything you have provided.
Yeah. Thank you. The pleasure is always ours, and we will continue to do this always. Thank you so much, Sri Lanka, and wishing you all the best from the entire team of iExam.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.